Well, what I would like to do is really to tell you the story of your life. You are not aware of it yet. But what you're going to experience in your lifetime is an amazing phenomena, and I would like to touch on that phenomena in the few minutes I have. I'm going to give you a very large perspective of this very day, this very year, 2014. Most of us, in order to understand the present, we go to the past. What we say in futures thinking is that if you really want to understand the present, you better go to the very far future and look at the present from that perspective. So that's what I'm going to do in the next 15 minutes. Actually, I was very much interested in those two questions. The first is there any way to foresee the future of Israel and world during the 21st century? Now, think about a whole century. What I can tell you is that many, many people have tried to understand the future of Israel, the future of world Jewry during the last century. Most of them have failed miserably to foresee what really happened. And of course, what I would like to a little bit to touch upon is the challenges that are going to be part of your life. If you think the challenges that you have just heard about are the challenges that are going to define your very personal life, be sure it's going to be very different. And I'm going to give you a very large perspective. Now, I'm going to say up front, what you're going to see right now is going to shake your view of what is it Israel at this point of time and what is it world Jewry at this point of time. And I'm going to tell you the very bottom line of my presentation. We are at the verge of something unusual in Jewish history. Very unusual, much more than what happened in the 20th century. The bottom line is, by the end of the 21st century, world Jewry and Israel is going to be very, very, very different than it is at this point of time. And I'm going to give you a little bit of what I think is going to happen, but if you really would like to go and delve a little bit deeper into what I'm going to present to you, this is a book I would like, I wish everybody would have the chance to take a look at. It is trying to do something which is very, very difficult to do by all means in futures thinking. What I said to myself in this book is, if I were in 1910 and I had in hand a reliable methodology, were I able to foresee at least 60, 70% of what happened from the beginning of the 20th century to the mid-20th century? I said to myself, if I had a methodology that could have figured out at least 60% of what happened, I'll be very glad to take that methodology and apply it to the 21st century. And that's what I did and came that book. I'm going to touch upon one single trend that I believe is very important for you to be aware of at this point of time in your personal life and in Jewish history. Okay, let me give you a very large perspective. As I said, I'm going to go back to the past, and I would like to hear from you. What do you think? How many Jews were in Israel 3,000 years ago? Exactly the time of King David, by the way. How many Jews were in Israel at the time? Would you like to guess? How many? Well, if you ask the religious narrative, you would go very easily to 3 million people. No way there were 3 million people here at that time. As far as we know from a scientific point of view, okay, we're speaking about between 50,000 Jews at the best, 300,000 Jews. Just think about Ir David, okay, Jerusalem. I bet you were We were there at least a couple times in the last year, here and there, a year at least. So we know that at the time, King David's capital was at best populated with 10,000 people. Now let's go forward in time. How many Jews now worldwide, 700 years ago, a very important time in Jewish history?
4 million.
How many?
4 million.
4 million, good.
12.
There you go, 1 million. Okay, now let's go forward. By the way, very important for you to note, 70% of world Jewry, which means 700,000 people, resided in Spain. Now, if you really want to understand a Holocaust, think about this number. It's not 30% that happened in the 20th century, it's 70% of world Jewry that really disappeared somehow. Now let's go forward in time. How many Jews were worldwide 200 years ago? 2.5 million.
8 million.
There you go. 3 million Jews. Okay? And then something unusual happened. In a matter of 140 years, world Jewry went from 3 million to
7 million.
There you go. Okay? Now, bear with me here. From here to here, world population went from 1 billion to 2 billion people. Jewish population did 6 billion, which is fascinating by all means. Now, there are a lot of reasons. Well, I'm not going to describe those reasons. I'm going to say something which is really very hard to speak about. Think if somebody was in 1910 watching, analyzing the trend, and the trends were very clear already in 1910. I don't think there was somebody that could have imagined the Holocaust. I don't think such a thing. But imagining terrible pogroms that was part of Jewish history in the last centuries. Now, this kind of growth, most of the time in history, in any kind of population, brings a reaction against it. And what the reaction we received in World War II. You know, I bet you understand and you know that the Germans, at the beginning, their motive, their slogans were, people, protect yourself from Jews. They were so afraid from this growth. And you all probably know that film of, you know, mice that are running and having offspring like crazy. This is exactly the challenge that was at the beginning of the 21st century. Nobody in world Jewry was able to understand it, to foresee the outcome. And the outcome was terrible. We were left with a third less of world Jew. How many Jews nowadays worldwide? You should know.
14.
Well, there is one person that is reliable to say the number. His name is Professor Drapergula from Hebrew University. And what he says is that in 2013, plus minus, about 13 million Jews, okay? Which means we barely started recovering from a terrible disaster that happened to us in the 20th century. Barely started recovering. Now, if you really want to understand 2014, remember those next two figures. If there was no Holocaust and there was a Jewish state, how many Jews would have been at this point of time in history?
40 million.
Okay. One person is reliable to say the number. Her name is Professor Anita Shapira from Tel Aviv University. She is really counting, okay, with a lot of methodologies. What she says is the following. If there was no Holocaust and there was a Jewish state, in 2013, there would be about 34 to 35 million Jews worldwide. This is the historical context that you and me are putting. It's a heavy load. Believe me, it's so heavy, we don't even understand that it's heavy. Another figure. If there was a Holocaust, and there was no Jewish state, how many Jews would have been at this point of time?
25 million.
According to Anita Shapira, would have been at this point of time between 6 to 7 million Jews only. Which means, if you really want to understand the fear, the driving force of world Jewry and of Israel specifically at this point of time, remember those numbers. And of course, you should all know how many Jews were here in 1948. Somebody knows? The Israelis here? About 600,000 people, okay? That's Jewish, okay? How many Jews nowadays in Israel? Jews. 6.2, okay? Which means this is the first time in Jewish history after 2,500 years, the first time that the largest Jewish community resides in Israel. The first time, and it's going to shape Jewish history in the 21st century. Of course, the largest Jewish community before World War II, it was in Poland, about 3 million Jews, and then from World War II until exactly a year ago, or a couple years ago, it was in the US. In the US, by all means, in any kind of count, it's about 5 million, 5.2 maybe at best. So this is the first time something is really happening. But the most interesting thing is how many Jews would be worldwide by 2050? And how many of them would be in Israel? Somebody would like to guess? 20 million. Okay, listen. First of all, this study was done in the Mossad Ne'eman in Technion. And what they are saying is that, of course, whenever we do those kind of things, we do three scenarios. The highest estimate, the minimum estimate, and the lowest estimate. What I'm going to show you is the medium estimate, which means it can be more than that, it can be less than that, it depends on what some things that might happen. So what we're saying at this point of time is that by 2050, we're going to get back into 18 million Jews worldwide, which means it's going to take about a century to recover from a terrible crisis, a terrible disaster that happened to us. Now, 100 years is really a lot in personal life, but 100 years in a community history or in a national, this is really nothing. Out of those 18 million Jews worldwide, there will be in Israel about 12 million Jews worldwide, and about another 3 million non-Jews, which means that Israel is going to double its population in the next 40 years, which is a phenomenon by all means, a phenomenon with a lot of challenges, with a lot of course of interesting things that might happen, good and not so good things, okay? But the most interesting thing that you're going to experience in your lifetime is the following slide. It's not my numbers, it is the UN numbers. They were published exactly a year ago. I would like you to take a look at them and then I'll discuss some of their implications. By the end of the 21st century, according to the UN, I believe it's going to be much more than that, but according to the UN, Israel is going to have 24 million people. It's going to be the only state, nation, that is going to triple its population. Worldwide population is going, we are now about 7 billion people, by 2050 world population is going to be around 10 billion people, but by the end of the 21st century, world population is going to shrink back between 5 to 6 billion people. So the world is going to experience a very, very challenging phenomenon. Because as far as we know, we have never experienced worldwide, humanity has never experienced such a growth and then such a collapse in actually no time. What does it mean economically? What does it mean geopolitically, etc., etc.? However, the Jewish people and the Israeli society specifically is the only nation that is going to triple its population. There are a lot of challenges that are coming up from this. What I would like you to take a look at is the other nations, those nations that were planning to eliminate the Jews in World War II. Take a look what happened, what's happening to them, and take a look at what's happening to Israel. Now, it's not only a matter of numbers. The Israeli population is going to be a very young population, which means it's going to be very vital, very innovative. If you think Israel is the startup nation right now, wait and see what those numbers are going to do to this society. Now, please, these kind of numbers are really going to have you ask a lot of questions. Don't hesitate, just send me an email. If I will be able to answer, I'll do it with really a great pleasure. But don't take those numbers so easily, because our surrounding world population is not exactly, doesn't really understand this phenomenon of Israel. We are at the verge of not just recovering from a terrible thing that we have to discuss and we have to explain, but we are at the verge of growth that never happened in Jewish history, by the way. As far as we know, there were never so many Jews worldwide in our history. There were never so many Jews concentrated in one single place. Because by 2050, there'll be about two-thirds of world Jewry concentrated in Israel. It's a challenge that we have never experienced, at least in the last 2,500 years. A lot of people are really terrified from that phenomena. And by being terrified means that nobody will be able to accept any kind of risk in this region. And because of that fear, you're going to see Israel very much aggressive in dealing with any kind of threats. So you are put in a time in history in which we have passed the time of just holding the numbers into the time in which we are going to start really recovering from the 20th century. And this is the context in which you and me are put. Basically, more you than me. So I will really urge you to take a look on those numbers, discuss those numbers, read a little bit about the implications of those numbers, because this is where you are put historically. If you will not understand it, you might continue trying to address the present challenges, which are definitely not what those numbers are speaking about. The future challenges are totally different than the challenges that we are dealing at this point with. I will finish by saying that I wish I was a little bit younger like you. Because this is the time that our forefathers have been dreaming about for millennia. And somehow, somebody has put you in that time. I wish I were young like you. Thank you very much.